Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I am going to discuss a topic which belongs to paper 1, unit 1. The topic is catalysis. In our previous class we have discussed, previous session we have discussed what is catalyst, what are the different types of catalysts, what is catalysis and what are the important characteristics of catalysis and what are the types of catalysis, that means types of catalytic reactions. Today let us consider an acid-base catalysis. First of all, let us know what is an acid-base catalysis. So these are actually the homogeneous catalytic reactions which are catalyzed by acids or bases, or both acids and bases. Okay, so these are the catalytic reactions, that means the homogeneous reactions catalyzed by either an acid alone or a base alone, or both an acid and a base. That's a mixture of both acid and bases. What are these homogeneous catalytic reactions? These homogeneous catalytic reactions are the ones in which the reactants and the catalyst, all the reactants and the catalysts are in the same phase. About this we have discussed in our previous session. Now let us consider in detail about this acid-base catalysis. According to Arrhenius, what is an acid? An acid is a substance, or an acid catalysis is brought about by H plus ions supplied by strong acids. Okay. Arrhenius defines acid catalysis as that reaction which is brought about by hydrogen ions supplied by strong acids. Let us consider the example of HCl. This HCl decomposes to give H plus and Cl minus ions. So if we use this HCl in the reaction, then as a catalyst, then the H plus ions, it is the H plus ions present in HCl which brings about the catalysis, and that becomes an acid catalysis. Okay, in the same way, what is a base catalysis? That means it is the catalyzed reaction which is brought about by the hydroxyl ions, OH minus ions supplied by strong bases. If you consider strong bases like sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, etc., they decompose giving Na plus and OH minus ions, that is hydroxyl ions. These hydroxyl ions, they catalyze the reaction, and that brings about base catalysis. To bring about an acid catalysis, the hydrogen ions given by the strong acids are responsible, and the OH minus ions given out by the dissociation of strong bases like NaOH, they bring about base catalysis. What are the examples for acid-base catalysis? There are plenty of examples, but I am mainly considering only two examples here. First one is mutual rotation, and the second one is acid hydrolysis of an ester. Because we are going to learn something in detail about these two, that is why I am considering only these two. But recently it has been shown that in acid catalysis, not only the H plus ions given by the dissociation of strong acids, but also some undissociated acids and cations of weak bases show catalytic activity. See, so far according to Arrhenius, only H plus ions donated by or obtained by the decomposition of strong acids are the are responsible for catalytic activity. But later and recent studies have shown that not only the H plus ions given by the strong acids, but also the undissociated acids. See, if there are some weak acids, they decompose partially, and undissociated acid molecules, they remain in the solution, they can also catalyze the reaction. And also the cations of weak bases, if you have a weak base, then it will decompose giving cation and anion, then this cation obtained by the dissociation of the weak base can also bring about the acid catalysis. Okay, let us consider the example of a weak, considering the weak base like sodium ammonium hydroxide. This ammonium hydroxide decomposes giving NH4 plus and OH minus ions. Ammonium hydroxide is a weak base. It decomposes giving NH4 plus ion, that is ammonium ion and OH minus ion. According to the recent studies, the NH4 plus ion, which is the cation obtained by the dissociation of the weak base, this cation, that is ammonium ion, can also catalyze the reaction. Okay, so in short, not just ammonium ion, all substances which have a tendency to give up a proton can show catalytic activity. All those substances which can give, which can form or which can donate a H plus ion during a reaction have the capacity to bring about or cause catalytic reaction. That means they are also responsible for acid catalysis. See, just like here I have considered NH4 plus ion. This NH4 plus, that is ammonium ion, it dissociates giving NH3, that is a stable molecule ammonia, and it gives out H plus ion. So this NH4 plus ion, it forms H plus ion, or it shows the tendency to give a H plus ion during the reaction. So because of this nature, this NH4 plus ion can act as a catalyst. It can bring about acid catalysis. That is the recent observation. So it is the nature of NH4, it is the tendency of this NH4 plus ion to produce or to give out this H plus ion is responsible for the catalytic activity. Okay, now let us consider what happens in the case of base catalysis. We have learned that in base catalysis, hydroxyl ions given out by the strong bases, by obtained by the dissociation of strong bases, are responsible for catalysis. But recently, it is shown that not only the hydroxyl ions, but some undissociated bases and even the anions of weak acids show the catalytic activity. Let us consider the example of a weak acid like acetic acid. Acetic acid is a weak acid, we all know that. It dissociates as below. It dissociates giving acetate ion and H plus ion. So it is the anion of the obtained by the dissociation of acetic acid is the acetate ion. So this anion can catalyze the reaction. So in general, or in short, all substances which have a tendency to accept a proton can show catalytic activity. So why does this acetate ion show the catalytic activity, or how does it is responsible for the base catalysis? This can be explained as below. Acetate ion shows catalytic activity because it has the capacity, or it has the tendency to accept a proton. Okay, so what is general? Next is general acid base catalysis. A reaction which is catalyzed by an acid is also catalyzed by any substance which has a tendency to lose a proton and is considered as general acid catalysis. That means if any reaction is catalyzed by an acid, that reaction is also catalyzed by a substance which has a tendency to lose a proton. Similarly, a reaction which is catalyzed by a base is also catalyzed by all substances which have the tendency to gain a proton, and this is known as general base catalysis. This discovery led to the development of modern concept of acids and bases. So what is this modern concept of acid and base? According to the modern concept of an acid is a substance which has the tendency to lose a proton, and base is a substance which has the tendency to accept a proton. Example, NH4 plus ion has the tendency to give a proton, therefore NH4 plus ion is an acid. Acetate ion, it has the tendency to gain a proton, therefore it can be considered as a base. Okay, so this is all for today's session. Thank you.